Come on, son. Give me the St. John 6:44. Go on, hit me, son. Clock me in. Thank the Lord. Ain't no use of working and you ain't clocked in. Isn't that right? I tell you, I'm just like the man told me in the 22nd chapter of the book of St. John, 22, 20 and by 4, told me to go in the vineyard and work. So whatsoever right, say, I'll pay it. Isn't that right? God said, whatever right. Folk don't realize that you do what you're supposed to do by God. God going to pay it. Y'all hear me? God going to pay it. I got folks sitting around here watching me right now in adultery. And you know what they waiting on? Waiting on God for how God going to move. He told me he was in it. He said, I was in it. He said, to him. He said, I heard you preaching. He said, that was hard. I had to move. You know why he had to move? God needs somebody to be a witness against these people. Let me tell you something. If I go along with women, not pastors, just preachers, that's all. If I went along with second wife, the first one you got, you weren't saved. This one you got, you saved. We'll pack this place out. We'll change. We'll have to go to back to church without walls. We'll have to call ourselves a church without walls. Because these folks will be spilling over. Ain't nobody trying. Folks ain't trying to live right. They'll pack in a place. Folks, you three not living right. Folks come sparing in between. Ain't that right? Folks don't want. You put a sign up for a job with some hard work. Ain't nobody trying to get that job. You trying to get too much for that little money. I know it. What these folks looking at, what they got to give up to serve God to really be saved. Same with a lot of y'all. You done got here and got comfortable. You going to mess up. There's some folks going to come. Going to show y'all out. I've been told y'all, God got some folks, he's going to prepare the hearts of these folks hearing that gospel. They're going to come to, they're going to sit down, they're going to be ready to serve. Y'all hear me? I'm trying to tell you, that's why I'm standing on the wall. I ain't moving. I don't want to have to give up my seat because I'm in the way and I won't do my job. When I had to give up my seat, I just can't do it no more. Y'all hear me? I ain't talking about I don't want to do it. I done got where age done got me. And that something done took me down and God said, another man got to take these people on. I don't want to be caught because you done laid down on the folk. You done forgot the word. I ain't going to do like these folks. I'm not going to walk off and leave no work. Y'all hear me? Somebody looking to be saved. Y'all hear me? For everyone on there, go make a hypocrite video about me. I don't go defend none of that. I don't watch. They be wasting time making a video. I don't watch that junk. Ain't that right? These folks, listen, I'm one only one they got standing. This what got me. How many going to make video about Eddie Long now? Because all of them in the same boat. Now, why? You would think all these folks so righteous. Why won't y'all make a video about a man sleeping with kids? All these right, why won't they go cut down these men sitting around saying, when you having sex with your husband and wife in their church, you having sex with Jesus, which is true. Right. When you sleeping with your wife or your husband and you in the church, you having sex with Jesus. Because right. You're not sleeping with no Yeshua.
Amen.
Isn't that right? The whole world going away backwards. Yeah. Right. Why do you folks want to sit around and fight men standing up telling these people the truth? They got to make up a lot. You got people you ain't got to make nothing up on already filthy and dirty, and they won't even say nothing about them. I look on one guy, said, this fellow, some big pastor, he said him with his penis on the sink, now send it to another man. He said, I ain't even going to fight. I read his story. I didn't know the picture was on now. I'm reading this story. He leaned on the back of a chair telling him how, you know, you done seen it. He ain't even going to fight the story. It's what it is, whatever it is. He done stepped down. I'm strolling on down through the story. Fella Sloan laying on the sink. Listen, not one comment, one person out of every comment on that was weighing him out. One person talking was false. A lady said she was wrong. Another one, they're saying he can beat me with that rod of correction any day. Listen, every one of them down the whole county. That's why I stick behind my black men. This is your leader? But then again, he knew. That's why he said, who gonna condemn him? One lady out of the whole group had something to say. I said, why you think these people won't change? The people love wrong. These people don't want nobody holding no standard. They'll rather waste time billing lies. Do you know Tony Smith married his brother? Why my brother ain't came out and told him? How much common sense it take that people want to sit here and believe something a flat out lie? What kind of fools this is? The stupid, retarded stuff these people going made by me don't even make sense. They got people that are actually marrying their wife, marrying their brothers. Sleeping with their kid. Earl Polk was sleeping with his own granddaughter. Had a baby by his brother's wife, and his brother told me it was okay. Not one video been made about itself for me. The folks told me on the TV, said, you can't talk about it. The man told me at the TV station he owed him $25,000. I paid a month in advance before we came on. He said, we can't put him on. He said, he owed him $25,000. Still coming on, flashing. Why? And told him I can't talk about it. That's what kind of hypocritical America we live in. Sex with your 8 girl grown, she said, granddad been sleeping with me since I was 8. He been sleeping with other members in the church. Been sleeping with his brother-in-law wife. Sleeping with his brother wife. His nephew, his son. Man, I ran through folk. They go gay. And you tell the truth on and you wrong. Folk lie on me. That sound like Tony Smith. Seem like I heard somebody come out say he was gay. If these folk could come out and prove I'm gay, man, I'll burn in hell. Where my gay lover? My gay lover, you come out, I don't know where I'm going to get the money from. I ain't going to lie. But I'm going to get you $1 million some kind of way. In allotment, my gay lover, come on out and expose me. I ain't got it now, but we'll get it. Because if I'm gay, I ain't no use to hold no standard. Might as well go, I'm going to get it. You just come on out, I'm going to get it. Don't worry about it, I got it. Once he expose me, I'm gay, what I'm going to do then? Try to hold a standard? Come on out, expose me, I'm gay, then I'm going to get you your $1 million. Well, I'm going to say, it's time to get right. I ain't used to time getting right now. I've been gay all that time. I ain't used to trying to get straight now. I ain't even going to go after no repentant for it. I've been gay. Let me just go on. I'm going to get you. You come on out, nigga. I'm going to get your money. These broke niggas ought to be knocking the door down. I don't see one yet. Y'all, let me tell y'all something. Well, y'all ain't got to worry about me shaming y'all. I know a whole lot of them done said it. I know. I ain't the only one. Oh, they all say that. God be the one gonna vindicate. God be the one justifying. Y'all hear me? There's one of the little secret sisters I've been putting on the back. Like I told you, if me and her went to the hotel and we changed our mind, we ain't even take the clothes off. Man, I don't get no repentance. Is that good? Me and her called and talked about it on the phone about doing it. And we ain't even do, we just talked about it on the phone, said, oh, let us stop. We need to stop this and get right. May I get no repentance and burn in hell. That put it tight. Tell the other priest, I want everyone made it. Go say the same thing. Fella made video about me being picked up twice for picking up homosexuals in the parking lot. Picking up women. Prostitute. Get what he was doing? Ministering to him. Or administering to him. He just happened to get caught twice coming out from the church, helping a prostitute pick him up in the car, in the parking lot. And the police, for whatever reason, pulled over and stopped him and wrote him a ticket for soliciting prostitution. A prostitute. If you ain't got your clothes on, y'all sitting in the church parking lot talking, how you wind up getting the charge? Twice. You thought I believe these sorry niggas? What's it ain't Digital Flavor? Oh, that was beautiful. They made a video of me. Do y'all know when that video come out, ain't nobody gonna come and join him? They made a video coming out. Listen, the preview was better than the movie. That thing was so hot. Y'all remember that? Coming soon, May the 6th. I'm a guy, listen, they made a bit, they said, they said, when this come out, there will be nobody left him and nobody ever gonna come. Cause you know they gonna send that DVD over the whole world. I wonder when mine gonna get in the mail. Been about 5 years, I ain't got, how many of y'all got y'all video? Man, folks ain't nothing but disgraceful. Folks sit up here, I went on talk show. Woman sit here, masturbate on the phone, married. On the phone, tell her home when he get home, what you been doing? Oh, on the phone, masturbate with my boyfriend. Woman admits that any guy she talks to, if he listen to her, she has sex with him. Am I lying? The woman talks to a boyfriend and agreed to give him the address of where her and her husband, her sons live, so he can come there and kill her husband. Y'all remember that? Yeah. I said something, know what they said? Forgive her! And I'm still a false prophet. I told him, I wish a nigga would call me by coming to my house to kill me. I don't even want you to burn all your gas. I'll meet you. What kind of mind these people got? What kind of mind people got in the world today? Where is the standard at? Does anybody believe God's word?
Not many.
If you're going to be saved, you got to stand on God's word. Y'all know what? You're going to have to cry. You're going to have to go without. You're going to have to suffer. You're going to have to be embarrassed. You're going to have to be shamed. But at the end of the day, only one thing I'm worried about. can I be saved? At the end of the day, when folk get through laughing, shaming me out, embarrassing, can I be saved? That's all I want to know. Y'all hear me? That's all I want to know. Can I be saved? At the end of the day, that's all that matters. Can you be saved? That's the only thing that matters when it comes down to it. St. John 6:44. Y'all feel how hot it is in here? If y'all fanning, you don't want to go to hell. You see me wiping. I don't want to go to hell. Isn't that right? Whatever it takes, I don't want to go to hell. I'll suffer. Whatever it is, Lord, hold my hand. I said, hold my hand, guide my feet. I don't know what I'm going to have to suffer before I get out of here. But whatever I do, Lord, don't let me go to hell. Amen. I don't want to turn from God's word and wind up going to hell. Every one of y'all in here, whatever you do, hold God's hand. If he leads you, you won't fall. If you continue in the faith, rooted and grounded, and be not turned away from the hope of the gospel, which will preach to every creature, that's what you got to do. It takes something. Listen, you're going to see more folk walk away than you're going to see stand. You got to believe God's word. That's all I got. At the end of the day, that's all I got. If you go out there and count my car, I ain't got nothing. My house, my clothes, the little money in my pocket, nothing I got. I ain't got nothing. But I got a soul. My soul got to be saved. That's why I'm here. You think I ain't never thought about walking away? You think I ain't never thought about throwing the towel in and quitting? You think I ain't never thought about giving up? Let me tell you something. I told y'all that before. I remember early in my ministry, asking God to let me just go ahead and mess up so I could just get out of the way. People were coming at me so much telling me that you can't do it. It was good, I want to do it, and I was setting myself up for a fall. They said, because you keep trying to live too perfect. That was a lie. Young man too here, and I'm in my 20s, hearing that and telling me I can't. They was more experienced. They had churches, members. They had the money. They ain't have to work for nothing. They had already gotten to where I was trying to hope one day to get to, not for the sake of the money, but you want to see growth behind your work. And they telling me, I was just sitting, I was shooting myself in the foot. All I was doing was setting myself up for a big fall. I was trying to be too perfect. I was tearing down other preachers. That's not how brothers supposed to do. Brother in love supposed to continue, how brothers supposed to cover each other's sin. I just wrote, I said, maybe it's me. I thank God for that day. God could answer my prayers. I wouldn't be standing here now. It's since you asked for it. Since that's what you want, I'll give you mine. Go ahead and do it. I thank God for every prayer he don't answer. Because had God answered, I wouldn't be fit to stand here today. And all we need is one more off the wall. Let me tell y'all something. Somebody trying to get home. Y'all hear me? Amen. Somebody believing. Somebody watching, knowing if ain't nobody else standing, they know it wasn't standing. Y'all hear me? Well, who you know doing it? I'm standing on it. Y'all hear me?
Amen.
I'm able to lead every one of y'all, a brother, a sister, wife, and whether the rest of it. If you follow, I lead it where you got to go. Isn't that right? I'm standing. So y'all think when you fall in a situation, don't think I don't know. Don't think I hadn't been there. It's just the fact you got to make yourself accountable to somebody. I started looking, I'm accountable. Somebody looking. That was easy. I didn't have my family and a couple of more people. So it wasn't like I would have hurt a whole bunch of people, but God knew eventually there was going to be some people going to be watching. Somebody going to want to be saved. Huh? God knew after a while, somebody going to want to be saved. I done set you up and I done ordained you to do something. I done set you up that one day somebody going to find you and see you. Somebody want to be saved. When y'all get tired and feel like all hope is gone, that's when you got to stand the most. Don't even waste your time asking God what let you go head on. Ask God, Lord, help me to stand. Like that song, brother, Lord, help me to stand. Y'all hear me? That's all. God, help me to stand. Y'all hear me? It takes something to get. I told you, it don't take nothing to quit. What it take to walk off? I got how many folk gone? They ain't stopped the movement of God's work. At the end of the day, God got people out. They ain't going to be saved. Whether I do it or whoever, I wasn't going to stop the work. Nobody that stopped whatever you doing, you ain't going to stop God's work.
Amen.
Y'all hear me? Amen. Don't even sit around and count that to your heart. Make sure you get yourself right, folks, while you're here. Amen. Don't let all your going, don't let all your praying, don't let all your singing, don't let all everything you do with God, don't let it be in vain. Yeah. Come on, son, St. John 6 and 44. Brother, brother, get me 1 Corinthians 9 and 1. Thank the Lord. Listen, St. John 6 and 44. Listen.
No man can come to me except the Father which have sent me draw him.
How is you going to do it? How you going to come and God don't let it in your heart? That young man sitting on the other side of the wall over there made a move to say, I'm 51 years old and I don't walk out. You can't do it, let God call you. Tell why he don't follow me. Everybody, he showed me a letter his daughter wrote to him. I was sitting there, daughter, he wrote a letter to him and tell him, I love you, daddy. Said, whatever you're going to find, I hope you find it. I know you think we don't love you. He said that, he said, you know how hard that was to walk off my daughter, put a picture on there, told her I love you. But he said, you know what? I can't help them till I help myself. You know if more people had a mind like that? More folk now, you trying to force and make folk, they ain't their mind. First thing you look, when God give you a mind to hear God's word, I know what I heard. When Paul said they all had all fallen to the earth, he said they seen a light, they ain't hear no voice. He said, but he spoke to me. When you know God speaking to you, you can't worry about who else. Don't. Did you hear that candidate? He was talking to me. Amen. Y'all know God talking to you, you hear the word, folk. That's when you got to make sure, you got to get yourself responsible, get yourself saved. Quit sitting around waiting on other folk to do. You hear the word, you know what you got to do for yourself. That's a beautiful way when a husband and wife can go the same way and kid. But at the end of the day, save yourself. Sometimes I don't see how many couples. I seen Hogan them sit all that time. All of you, ain't no way in the world I could sit beside nobody for no years and you walk, I walk. You crazy? What was I sitting for? What was I praying? Why was I on my knee praying? Who was I singing and lifting up hands to? Why was I being anointed?
Right.
What do you believe?
Amen.
Boy, I why too many folk make too many decisions. Why did the price turn around and go backward? Why are they trying to tell me? Anytime you get a spot and they tell you, say, listen, honey, this agreement we're going to make. If any one of us leave, you, the other one take the child and stay him. Now, that nigga told me that I already know some junk going on. You just told me something. I ain't no mother talking about leaving a child. Already here, right there. That's the set right there done got you messed up. Why are you talking about somebody stay here and one of them go, who you plan on leaving? Because I hadn't planned on going nowhere. Because folks already know, I'm the type of nigga, I like to move and play game. I'll shoot out and I'll leave you somewhere. And that to tell you two, don't follow me. If I tell you one of us stay now, whichever one go, the other one stay and keep the kid there. Because I'm already telling you I'm finna turn and burn on you. All right, I made that agreement. Listen, I told you folks, a lot of y'all got too many other options. That's what hurt you. Options hurt you. I ain't got no options. Where I'm going to go? Unlike Peter, when the rest of them walked off, where I'm going to go? He got the words he turned. Where I'm going to go? What I'm going to do when I turn from this? What church I'm going to sit in and let some man teach me? What Seventh-day Adventist movement I'm going to go sit in? What Hebrew Israelite I'm going to sit around and let Drake be a smoke reef and try to tell me what God's words say? How am I going to get another wife and tell myself what? I look at Shandrick, before she came, she already knew the teacher. Born and raised one husband, one wife. Born and raised never eating pork or shrimp in this stuff. Born and raised with the Sabbath day, keeping the Sabbath and keeping all the feast days. Soon shot the door, went right out where her heart was. I said, look at God. God will show you that being born in something ain't enough to get you. Isn't that right? It got to get in your heart. This thing got to get in your heart. You got to feel God for yourself, folks. Every one of y'all in here, y'all better start learning to feel God. You can't let other folk get you and get you out of no mess. None of y'all. You got to look, consider yourself. End of the day, ain't no preacher, ain't none of these, listen, go ahead and get butt naked. I don't care. You put butt naked, all kind of slipper all on you. Only way it's going to make me lay with you, I got to want to do it. That just been, that didn't find that butt naked slippery all in it. So the gentleman, where they get that from anyway? Stop it. What I'm trying to tell you, ain't nobody can make you do nothing you don't want to do. And you should try to look, I ain't trying to blame nobody. You got to sit down and consider yourself. Y'all hear me?
Amen.
You can't blame other, but you got to set your mind on, I'm accountable. I got to give an account for what I do. At some point, you got to look at folks, y'all got to condition yourself to do better.
Amen.
Come on, son. No man can come unto me except the Father will send me do what?
Draw him.
And I'll do what?
Raise him up at the last day.
Tell him what's written, son.
It is written in the prophets.
And they shall all do what?
Be all taught of God.
These folks say they want to. I've been taught of God.
Amen.
Y'all know what? I thank the Lord. I've been taught of God. Everything makes sense. It all makes sense. You got to be taught of God. It makes sense even if Peter give me no name. It makes sense. You got to be taught. Every one of us sitting here, a lot of y'all done took this teaching for granted. That's why you wind up slipping off. That's why you start messing up. That's why you start getting comfortable. You start making friends with folks. You forget. Listen, I got friends. I got folks. We came. We do stuff together because we have certain things in common. We do that. Their decision making ain't finna call me go do nothing wrong, though. That had nothing. A lot of y'all, I tell you, don't deal with weak folks. You'll mess up. Well, other folks, that ain't got nothing to do with me. I still got to be responsible for myself. I know with Leon, you know, he wasn't that strong. And me and Leon wasn't that strong. Leon, it ain't going to be no Leon and Tony. Y'all got me?
Amen.
Because you got to consider yourself. There's no way in the world you're going to avoid everybody weak and everybody wrong. It's not possible. Then you learn to condition yourself to look at, regardless of what other people do, I got to be saved. Every man, therefore, that had heard
and have learned of the Father
cometh where, son?
Unto me.
Come unto the 24th chapter book of Ezekiel. I know I call that 1 Corinthians 9 and 1. Thank the Lord for the new moon, the fourth month.
Amen.
Thank the Lord for the truth. Isn't that right?
Amen.
Ain't but one truth. Everybody say ain't gonna be saved, got the same truth.
Amen.
Y'all hear me? Everybody say and everybody gonna be saved, believe the same thing. Otherwise, we're gonna have a division. I had a gentleman I talked with back and forth asking me about some movement, the GMOC, whoever that is. Yeah, they're supposed to be some Hebrew Israelite. I guess they teach about not keeping the Sabbath. I thought I wouldn't even know. I don't listen to any other preacher.
Amen.
Anybody send me a video of another preacher with their preacher, you just waste your time. I can't watch that stuff. I'd be disobedient what he told me. Then they come unto me and bring out their doctrine. He told me not to receive in my house, need to bid on God's speed. Said he that bid on God's speed be partaking evil deed. I been broke when I'm joking my house, then find out, oh, you owe. Does that change what I was told? Don't gamble with it. If you got a man teaching the truth, I don't know where folks looking for everything else. All that other experiment, reaching and grabbing, I'll mess you up. I can't, man, I don't be listening. I'm funny. I don't be listening to everybody. Been like that. Been cut that junk off. These folks will mess you up. Like, man, my soul too precious. Get to listen to one of these jokes, they don't slip something in there, I missed it and messed around, got caught on that thing, and I messed up. How much teaching I had to clean up for folks here listening to people? I'm Jay, you remember one time that fellow teacher, you can't have a double Sabbath? Man, I don't be listening to these people. It was best I'd never known that stuff. Folks mess you up so bad, and then you find out from during the Feast of Unleavened Bread, guess when you should die? Where they wind up in? A double Sabbath. Because he died when they would have put him in the ground, that would have been, by the time that came on, that was a Sabbath. Then they had the regular weekly Sabbath, double Sabbath. You take it away, they said you can never have a double Sabbath. These folks had everything else, and God let them get tripped up on some food that don't make sense. Every month, the Sabbath moved. I don't met these, man, I don't listen to any retarded people. They ain't even biblical. That about the Lord told the secret thing belong to who? But those things which are revealed belong unto who? So how we don't know it biblically? We probably had to find this in the scriptures. Where did you find the scripture that the Sabbath moved every month? Because these folks wind up messing up. Before you give them that 2 Peter 1:19. Make it 1:17. I love that book. Let these folks, man, these folks mess your mind. I don't listen to these people. Any Sunday worshiper. I was looking at the thing about that Church of Mice and them movement that wanted to debate me. These folks ain't even an inkling on mine. What? You know how dumb and retarded you got to be? First of all, Christian. Sunday worshiping, and you in the church. All these are three pro negative that make you go to hell. These are your pro con that make you go to hell right here. This is crazy. You're a Christian on Sunday, and you sit up here in a church. All three of these are wrong, gonna send you to hell. These are three main reasons why you ought to burn in hell. For the fact what you have is not written. It's not written concerning being in a church. It's not written concerning no Sunday worship, and it's not written concerning being no Christian. It's retarded. These people know their book being interpreted, but you know what? It said, Church of Might, like I told you, it started from a white religion. When white people give it to you, that's where you messed up at. Trace your religion back. Once it get there and you see the end of it white, take it and throw it in the trash. Because if it been white, it's already been tainted. It's just being honest. Where they get it from? If you find it in root back to somebody white and land up in Europe, you in trouble. What we got started Jerusalem. It started Jerusalem. Isn't that right? This is the place where the Most High God took Abraham and brought him over to Doel, over the plains of Mamre. Over in Hebron. I still started over there. Amen. These folks ain't got nothing. You gonna trace your jump back to Europe? You gonna trace your jump to South America? You gonna trace your stuff back to Asia? You ain't even got nothing. Folks, don't let nobody make no fool out of y'all. Come on, son. 2 Peter 1:17. Listen.
For he received from God the Father.
He received from God, the Most High God the Father. What did he receive, son?
Honor and glory.
Honor and glory.
When there came such a voice to him from the excellent glory.
Come on, son.
This is my beloved son.
In whom?
I am well pleased.
That's what we're working for. We want the Most High God to be pleased with us. Come on.
And this voice which came from heaven.
Did what?
We heard.
Come on, son.
When we were with him in the Kadesh Mount.
Listen.
We have also a more sure word of prophecy.
Whereunto?
Ye do well.
That you do what?
Take heed.
Hold before you get ready to go. He changed the word holy to Kadesh, which is right. How many of y'all seen the commercial for the new, what, the vacation movie? With Chevy Chase. How many of y'all remember that? You seen it? We seen it the other night. You seen the part where he was running through the cow pasture? He had his car. You heard what he hollered before he hit it? Holy cow. Holy cow. He just happened to throw that out in the movie. Holy cow before he hit it. Because it's Hindu. These people think if you holy, you saved. If you holy, you are contrary. You have to be Kodesh. All this we had to learn. All these conformities we had to learn. You know how it comes? It comes over a process of time of being taught. If it's your desire and real means to be saved, don't you know God gonna reveal what's right to you? We ain't went seeking nothing. God let one of our enemies throw it out here and we sort of said, that was what I said, we ain't gonna take it because it came from a sinner. If it's right, it's right. We moved from church then. What are we gonna do? We gonna keep being a church because it came from a sinner? If it's right, it's right. He's still a sinner that sent the information. He's still walking contrary, but God's word is right. Amen. Listen, God can use your enemies. Isn't that right? Amen. God can use your enemy, but the main thing at the end of the day, it brought us right where we need to be, in the truth. Y'all hear me? You ain't got to go seeking out all behind this star. You got to do make sure you're obeying what you got. If you're being consistent with what you got, folks, that's how you give more like you do. Who going to commit more to them that's unfaithful in the least? What you got, you've been messing up with it. Why God going to give you more? Come on, son, listen.
Whereunto you do well.
That you do
heed,
what?
That you take heed.
As unto a what?
A light that shineth in a dark place.
Come on, son.
Until the day dawn.
Until the who?
Day dawn.
And what else, son?
And the day star arise in your hearts.
Listen.
Knowing this first.
But know what?
No prophecy of the scripture.
Is of any?
Private interpretation.
What I've taught and I preach and I owe much to people, I may improve with the book. When I told him Yeshua was Lucifer, which was the day star, I was able to prove with the book. I can't go along. What I seen and what I put out the book is in the book. And if you can't see it, that's second. Hold what you got, 2 Corinthians 4:3. They said, well, Tony Smith preaching and we can't see it. Let's see if it's Bible. Listen.
But if our gospel be hid.
But if our gospel do what?
Be hid.
It is hid to who?
Them that are lost.
In whom?
The God of this world.
Had done what?
Blinded the minds of them which believe not.
Tell them why, Andre.
That's the light of the
glory. That's why they can't see it. That light will blind you. That light will get you. They mess around, let the God of their world blind their mind. That because they believe not. Lest the what?
The light of the glorious gospel of the Messiah.
Which is the who is the who?
The image of Yah.
Should do what?
Shine unto them.
That's day star. Only light we knew to shine was him. Ain't that right? It was darkened upon the faith. Then when the light came, the book told us in the book of John, the darkness comprehended it not. When the God of the world blind your mind, it's going to be hard for you to recognize light when it comes. That's why when they see me, it's easy to say, I'm a sinner. I'm going to hell. I ain't right. I'm a faggot. And this would be bad. They're in a church full of gays that saved. By their own account, they're a hypocrite. You know, Tom Smith a faggot, he going to go to hell. Whole church got gays. My gays saved. I know Tony Smith sitting around committing adultery. He's sleeping with them sisters. They pastor having sex with their sister. Is your pastor going to hell? My pastor saved. God forgave him. Everything they said, they just make a retarded fool. Y'all mind talking on the phone to that woman who was talking about being about gays? How gays say and everything. Then she told she hope my son be gay. I said, if they say ain't nothing wrong with it, why you hope my son be? It don't make sense. Because they ignorant. They know their stuff make no sense. They need me to go to hell so they can look right. But I thank God he ain't like man. Y'all don't realize a lot of stuff y'all giving to, people need you to do it so you can drop down and make them feel better about themselves. The way to get people to make a change, every one of you should feel bad about the person you are. That's how you make the change. As long as you feel good about yourself, you're doing something wrong, there's no chance of repentance. What's gonna make you turn? If I feel good about being a homemonger, if I feel good about smoking and drinking, what's my chance of repentance? Because I ain't got no mind to turn. What I'm doing don't feel wrong. What I'm doing don't convict me, so there's no reason to make a change to be saved. Y'all get the wrong impression. You should feel convicted. You should feel violated. You shouldn't feel no love. You should feel rejected when you turn from God's word. That should keep you to make you want to draw nigh to God and not turn away from it. Folks, you got to love people in their wrong. No, I ain't gonna love you in your wrong. When God loved you in your wrong? God never came and did nothing to me in my wrong.
That's right.
Can't sit that bill down. You know I love you. You keep that bill. When you ready to talk to me, you gonna get rid of that stuff. When you ready to come to me, you gonna have to get away from what you got. We the only people saying I made provision because we sit around looking at our own imperfections. God don't work that way. He told you how to draw nigh to me, then I draw nigh to you. You can't come to God with no cigarettes, no liquor, no alcohol, no adultery, no fornication, because God ain't gonna draw to you. He told you, ready to problem. You got to be taught of God. Only way you gonna have to come, you gonna have to learn. That's why he put you in a situation to correct you. That's why he put you in a situation where he chastised you, because he's trying to turn you away from what you're doing. At the 33rd chapter of the book of Job, at verse 14. Job 33:14. Thank the Most High God for the word.
Amen.
I can help this whole nation. Now, Obama, the Democrat, Republican Party, every candidate, they got liars, hypocrites. Every one of them rotten. Talking about folks trying to play black. Somebody sent me one, Hillary. Her husband did it. Yep. That white one from the NAACP, she had to come and say, I ain't doing no different than Bill Clinton did. I just didn't play the saxophone and smoke weed. Black folks ain't never hypocrite. They love Bill. They got a song at the end of Bill Clinton. That's right, I said it. Tell me he a black man. Then they gonna say have a problem when a white woman be president of NAACP. White folks see y'all ignorant niggas and laugh at you. They ignorant, they're hypocrite. Which way you gonna have it? It's an insult when somebody white try to be black. Bill Clinton did it. But you loved him. Cause they hypocrites. Sorry, jokers. I'll fight for her to get the job back. I don't even care about the organization. Soon as she get it back, then I'll rip the organization down. Tell her, you still a hypocrite. Then tell her, nigga, since she want to be black. Then I tell her, welcome to the neighborhood. Listen to the book. Job 33:14, listen.
For God speaketh once,
come on, son.
Yea, twice.
What man do?
Perceiveth it not.
You know what bad? God done talked to you through the law and the prophet, and they done spoke in the last day by his son. When y'all gonna hear it? God speaketh once, yea, twice. Yeah, man doth what?
Perceiveth it not.
That's the, but if our gospel be hid, it's hid to them that are lost. At what point do you start hearing God's word? Come on.
In a dream, in a vision of the night.
When deep sleep
falleth upon men.
What's going to happen at that point?
In slumberings upon
tell
the
me
bed.
What happened at that point.
Then he openeth the ears of men.
Hold what you got. Tell me what's happening at that point. God speaking one, yea, twice. Yet man believeth it, yet man perceiveth it not. In a what?
Dream.
What else, son?
In a vision of the night.
When what?
Deep sleep falleth upon men.
What happened, son?
In slumbering.
Tell me what's going on right here. The prophet. The prophet. God's sitting here trying to let the prophet talk to you, trying to tell. He's trying to tell. I spoke once, yea, twice, but you don't even perceive it. Deep sleep, when men slumber upon the bed, we're Yehuda. We're people, we're supposed to know this. A lot of times God is troubling us, trying to wake us to try to turn us from our pride. Trying to seal our instruction. That's why he give us teachers. That's why he give you pastors, according to my heart, that are going to feed you with knowledge and understanding. And it's bad that y'all sit here and you reject it. Come on, son. Other brother, give me the fourth chapter of the book of Hosea. Whose name means what? Help. Salvation. Hosea and Hosea mean the same thing. Come on.
Then he openeth the ears of men
and what?
Sealeth their instruction.
That he might do what?
Withdraw man from his purpose.
And do what?
Hide pride from man.
So let me ask y'all a question. When y'all sit down and you start hearing the word, and a lot of times y'all wonder why it's coming at me, why it's hitting me, You know why? Because God's trying to turn you from what you're doing. How long y'all going to continue to sit around as Elijah asked you? How long y'all going to halt between two opinions? I know it's a several of y'all from the other end of that camera sitting in that room. Y'all halt between more than one opinion. The God that done answered, the God that done created and done made and established, done spoke to you and told you, but y'all still holding to some other thing that going to cause you to go to hell. That's a bad mind. That's a bad mind. Every one of us in here, we got opportunity, chance today to do something you never did in your life, you ain't never did. Get your soul saved. You can keep doing things the way you've been doing and keep going the way you're going. You hadn't accomplished nothing. I hadn't seen one success story that walked out that door and came back. I ain't seen nobody walked out with nothing and came back with everything successful, but back to the truth. Don't make sense. Only way they're going to make it when they got there, they're going to have to sell out more, and it ain't going to work for you. Once you don't sit here and you don't heard the truth, you make your mind to sit out there, it's only going to get worse. God's going to intensify for you. You done heard the word. Peter done told you clearly in 2 Peter, the third chapter, second chapter, it's better for you not to know the way of condition than to know to turn away from it. That's what y'all don't even consider. A lot of folks don't realize the opportunity chance y'all got. You'd be a fool to turn away from it. You'd be a fool to let it go. What you going to do out there? How you going to survive? Everybody, listen, car crash come up, little fender bender. Don't nothing get bent and you die. Everybody else survived. Nobody else hurt nothing. You wind up dying. Everything you do gonna be death to you because you done heard the word. Every one of us, we don't hear this word without no accountability. God done revealed to y'all here. This is a secret thing. God done revealed this to everybody. Why y'all think so many people in churches?
Amen.
Why y'all think so many people Christian? Because God done revealed this to everybody.
Amen.
He done revealed it unto us.
Amen.
And to our children, even all this law that we might even do it. And y'all sit here, you don't even get a more earnest heed to the things you heard. Y'all don't even consider, y'all let this stuff slip. You know when y'all think about it? After you mess up. That bad, it don't do me no effect after. I gotta think about it before it happens. Every decision got consequences. Every decision. I go take my last dollar, put it in a slot machine. Decision. I can wind up hitting, I can make more money, and this dollar can multiply. Or this last dollar I got to be everything I got and lose it, and then I still got to give an account for it. You know what you do? Put that dollar back in your pocket and keep moving. I ain't lost nothing, Boston. I ain't lost nothing. When I put it in now, even if I win, God can sit there and blow on it and it'd be the worst thing I ever got. So it's just do better, just hold on and let God multiply. How God gonna multiply by me being obedient. God gonna multiply by me doing what I'm supposed to do. I'm gonna bring the tenth into the house of God.
Amen.
Y'all hear me? He told me to bring all the tithes into the storehouse so it'd be meat in mine house. Prove me this day and see I won't open you a window to heaven and pull you out a blessing. It won't be room enough to receive it. These dumb folks rented Las Vegas with a hat. All the money on a hat. Nigga, that ain't from God. He said, what I'm going to give you ain't going to be room enough to receive it.
Amen. That's
but people right. Don't want how God paying dividend. They don't think about it. If I go to bed tonight, I don't have high blood pressure or diabetes. I ain't thinking nothing about it when I get up in the morning. I don't have it. Because I ain't have it last night. If I wake up the next day after that and I ain't have it, and I wake up and don't have it, I ain't thinking nothing about that. Until something happened, I get it. Now I consider. I had some good days. God, look at, I bless you more than monetarily. That's why we mess up. If we don't get a raise, we don't get a promotion, we don't get something, we ain't got nothing from God. You got a mind to hear God's word. You got another day opportunity. You got life in your body. And you got a mind. Y'all better start thanking God. You don't think like that. Y'all start looking at your condition of what you ain't got. There's a whole lot of things that you do have, though. Y'all hear me?
Amen.
You got a lot of stuff people ain't gonna never get. Have a mind and not of what God got going on, people ain't gonna get that mind. You don't just chance up on that. God got appointed for you. He told the apostle, you didn't choose me, I chose you. Now one of y'all chose to be here today to watch the turn. The brother on the other side of that wall, you think he chose to get up and leave his family and come here? Could have did if he wanted to. Nobody rational in their right mind would sit down and look at their family and tell their kids they gonna leave and they finna go in search of God and be saved. Not nobody in their right mind. You gotta have a mind God gotta give you. That's right, the Mashiach, the Most High God got to give you that mind. You ain't going to do it. That's why I said you can't come under me. You can't do it except I draw you. No, anybody he talked to, right, said, I'm going to be under with you. It's churches around him. Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you what I would do. I wouldn't do it. That's the problem. Because you're looking for a church that's some Greek that made up by idol God, got idol God attached to it, and you sat around and you ain't got no mind to be saved. So it makes sense. That's why I'm doing it, because you wouldn't do it.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Amen.
So you can't look and judge yourself by these people. You're going to mess up every time. Folks, y'all got to lay the heart and point. Y'all, what happened? Y'all consistently doing the same thing, and sometimes you get comfortable and you don't consider. It's just the grace of God. It's just the grace of God. You know how many people done did this Sabbath after Sabbath after Sabbath? They stopped. Yep. How many people done did it Wednesday after Wednesday? They stopped. Yep. How many people done made feast after feast? They didn't stop. Yep. You can't do it yourself. God showed it to you. God got to reveal it to you. God got to put it in your heart. God got to give you a mind to do this. And y'all are sitting around and fighting the will of God. That's crazy. They're like the book. Who have resisted his will and prospered? Who resisted God and prospered? He told Moses, for that same call have I raised up Pharaoh. I raised this man up to show you what happened when a man resists what I tell him. To show you what happened when a man begged for repentance and turned back to the same thing that he told me he wasn't going to do. God raised him up to show that to us. We missed it, didn't we? Y'all all right?
Amen. Amen.
Why am I telling y'all all this? Y'all get too comfortable. Y'all, I tell y'all all the time, y'all laughing, y'all get it going, ain't gonna be a snap to you. Don't let nobody carry you to hell. Folks, this is the most critical thing every one of us here is gonna do it for in our life. We've been living so long, we ain't really experienced, we hadn't experienced death. So it's real easy to keep doing things and assume. Maybe God will give me another chance. Maybe nothing will happen. Maybe I won't get caught. Maybe I'll be all right. Maybe things will work out. With my soul, I can't chance off that.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Yes, sir.
I can't chance off that. You got to sit down. You got to weigh every situation when you start to look at your soul. People sit down and budget their last piece of money, bend their will, their soul. You only got one. All you got to do is budget wrong and lose it. You can't get another soul. You can get a chance that somebody can loan. If you ain't got no money, you a pretty good guy. I like it. I'll loan you something. So if you lost everything you had, you ain't without. I'll give you that. But if you lose that soul, I can't give you that. People don't realize why y'all press and why God set the way up to be as hard as it is for y'all. Because everybody that get concerned about their soul, you gonna have to consider why you're going. All them stumbling blocks and hurt that get in your face, it make you realize why you're going. It's my soul. I know people say, you can't miss one time. You can't lay out. You can't do nothing. You can't go nowhere. It's about my soul. And God, look, God leave every entertainment just tonight even better than it was back when I was entertained by it. Huh? The movie they used to cuss when I cut, they cuss better now. Everything looks better. The naked picture, you can look through the girl leg and you can see her tongue, tons of dangling. They show everything. They weren't even showing all that back then. Because you know what God look at? If you get concerned about your soul, you'll forget about that. You ignore it and you're still on the path. That's when you start seeing growth. Isn't it a mere fact, unlike these people, God ain't never took nothing away from me, no cigarettes, no alcohol. People talk about, God gave me the word, and if you love me and you keep my commandment, you'll stay away from me. That's how it works. I did all that. If you take the taste of marijuana, God ain't taking no taste of marijuana. He ain't put it in there. God ain't taking no pop. This beer tastes like pee. Scary part. So when was you drinking pee? What you need to be asking God for, take the pee out your mouth. Right. Beer ain't nothing but cornflakes in a can. But you got a bigger problem. You talking about it tastes like pee. So how long you been drinking pee? Some of them thinking about, somebody used to call you Mr. Peabody. Ain't too bad, is it? I might use that on the road. Thank you. You're too kind. But the mind becomes this, people. You have to actually sit down and consider when you're looking at your soul, all of the variables. Since you only got one, is it really worth chancing? Every desire you had as a sinner, those same desires will come up as becoming or already being a saint. You have to have restraint. That restraint comes in with the discipline of the word. People say, how you say, I was a person, when I sat in the pew, I ain't had no discipline. Not having discipline, no matter how much I wanted not to shack up or fornicate, no matter how much I didn't want to smoke or drink, it was going to come again. It was going to come again because I lived an illusion. I kept waiting on God to make women unattracted to where I didn't desire them, so that way I won't fornicate. That God would make marijuana stink. That God will make beer taste nasty, awful. There'd be no looker around me or any of these things will happen. None of it happened. I live in illusion. I assumed that everything was going to be on God. In 2 Corinthians, the 7th chapter, we learn, having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let who? Us cleanse who? From all filthiness of the what? And what else we have to do? All that's telling me to do that. All that's me. I got the promise from God, but the only way to be a recipient of the promise, I got some things I got to do. The problem you got with Christians and them being saved is, the Christian, they ask them, ask me how I got, what I had to do to get saved, or how much it cost me to be saved, whatever. Cost me nothing. I ain't had to do nothing, my brother. See, I can tell you ignorant. It was all Jesus. See, God do it. That's the problem right there, Boston. See, you worry about what all you ain't got to do nothing, my nigga. Jesus saves. Only thing Jesus gonna do, if you don't got a taco lunch in your throat, he don't give you a Mexican hymen. That's how he gonna save you. If you in the river and you floating down the Chattahoochee in the mess, Jose gonna pull you out. Cause that's what he do. He swam down in the poopy creek. Don't let nobody make no fool out of you. All God did is one thing. God gave us the word. Amen. When you hear the word, then that had to become a matter of you considering. How did man get in the position? Because of sin. Sin came in because of transgression of the law. So let's consider. God's word was there before man's desire was to transgress it. When God's word and law and statutes got there, man has to make a desire, make a conscious decision that he sets and he considers. What are the stipulations involved with these laws and statutes? If I don't do it, I'm going to surely die. If you look at even when he spoke to our forefathers, they said, let not y'all speak with us, lest we. It's always been on the response end of, you've got to comply. If God got to come back and strain you, if God got to come back and deal with you, what you think going to happen? God left us laws and statutes, and it's your job not to impede them. It's your job to make sure you stay strict, to make sure you obey them. Your whole life, your whole existence is based on God's word. You nothing without God's word. All you see when you watch people driving, smoking, drinking, cussing, dancing, pool party, whatever they doing, they nothing. You can't be nothing without God's word. Because you have no restraint. God's word gives us discipline. That's why we're Yehuda. We're disciplined to God's word. We're people that trace back to being the Hebrews. We know our existence came in because God spake a word to our father Abraham. God made promises to Abraham and to his seed that there be a people that would continue in God's truth that would inherit the promise. That's us. But you can't inherit it if you're disobeying and you're transgressing, folks. The people he gave it to them because they believed God. You got to believe God rather than fornicate. You got to believe God rather than drink and tell lies. You got to believe God rather than shack up and commit adultery. That's why these people will not be saved. God called for these assemblies that we should gather and be here and we should do these things. Man say you don't have to do it. That Hebrew Israelite group that'll tell you, if you got to work on the Sabbath, God understands. But you do believe the Sabbath. If you believe it, you ought to walk in it. Amen. There's no way in the world you're going to tell me I believe in the Sabbath. I don't keep it, but I'm still going to be saved. If I offend anyone, I'm going to be guilty of all of them. I guarantee you they ain't all I'm going to be falling short on. I'm going to be falling short on everything. Because when I make that exception for the Sabbath, there's going to be some other exception going to come in for the others. Y'all hear me? And it only gets worse. We have to keep a strict diet. We have to keep a strict way. That's the only thing keep us safe. Sometimes y'all look at it's getting tighter. It look like you can't do nothing. Look like you can't go nowhere. If you do, you're going to wind up out here like the rest of these people. Y'all hear me? You got to stand up, folks. You got to take your punishment for what you've done. At the same time, you got to come in compliant. I ain't justifying nobody committing no sin. You commit sin, you are the devil. You know who sinned from the beginning? Devil did it. You don't want to be the devil? Obey God's word. It's unfortunate. Duke got some devils. Somebody else got some red devil. God ain't got no devils.
Amen.
It bad these folks to go to these schools and wear shirts and put stuff on, have no idea what they're saying. Y'all hear me? All devils wrong. All there ain't gonna be no blue demon, no red demon, no demon they got. You supposed to be a child of the Most High God.
Amen.
The only way you do that, you gonna comply with God's word. Amen. Everybody here, cleanse your heart. Cleanse your mind. Your soul on the line. What you gonna do if you die? Your soul gonna be required. Every one of us saying your soul gonna be required. Every day you gotta keep searching yourself. Every day when you get tried, you got to stand. You got to ask God to lead you and guide you. But you got to keep your mind on it. Yes, sir. Y'all get too much other junk going. I tell you, association with folk going to mess you up. Paul done told you, evil communication corrupt good manners. Awake to righteousness and sin not. Yes, tell me you can't do it. You got to be able to do it. Why God going to tell me? You know, so God ain't no better than the white man. He gonna tell me to do something I can't do. The American, white man done told me to be an American. I can't be an American. Now God done told me not to commit sin. I can't do that. I'm in bad shape. That means everybody lied to me. I know God ain't told me to do nothing I can't do. Amen. But you got to have in your heart, you got to want to do it. You got to have in your heart. I appreciate y'all that pray for the new moon. A lot of folks don't think, hey, what is it? I mean, you can stay at home. You can watch it. At some point, I tell everybody, hey, you got to do something different. If you're looking to be saved, you're going to have to do something different. You can't look to be saved doing the same thing you're doing. At some point, some got to make you stand out. 18th chapter, if you would, 18th chapter of the book of Luke. 18 and 1. I'm going to get them through with him. I got a whole lot of stuff you need to know. The problem is, do they want to know it?
Amen.
Whole lot of stuff. Y'all need to know a whole lot of stuff. Y'all need to consider. Whole lot. I know y'all got your mind on trying to get married. What you going to do when you get married? Go in there and stink up some bed sheet. Ain't going to be from the sex. It's going to be from the mess coming out your behind because you know you ain't going to wash it. Oh, it's disgusting. But they'll do it. You go get something and you ain't going to get it the right way, it ain't going to profit you. It ain't going to profit. That's why I tell folks a lot of times, folks will come at me about this one or that one. Let me get this one. Let me get that one. I can help y'all and tell you. You ain't going to be satisfied because you ain't going to get it right. That's what he told you, by the way. You ain't going to prosper just. It ain't going to do you no good. A lot of y'all want something for the sake of you seeing somebody else win it. Don't mean it's going to work for you, though. Y'all hear me? A lot of stuff ain't good. You know, you got to learn, look at what other folk got and say, it must fit them, they got it. And then when you see God take it from them, you realize, didn't fit them either. A lot of stuff you see folk with, don't mean it fit them and go to them, it's just folk hard-headed. You see folks say, I ain't never had a sick day. I eat shrimp and all the time. I put salt on my stuff. When people salt, I put more on it. You keep doing it. After a while, it'll come back to you. God got folk, he set up. And God got way sure, said, this is the right way, walk in it.
Amen.
Isn't that right? These folks sit out here and they be a snare to you. I've been watching these folks out here. You watch these people, they'll snare to you. Don't nobody make no fool out, you know. Yeah. Call these people living it. These people ain't died yet and went in no judgment. Yeah. I don't count that. Oh, they got away. Had they gone to judgment? No. Had they escaped judgment? No. You ain't got away. Y'all hear that, but how are we going to escape if we neglect so great salvation? Yeah. Ain't nobody going to get by.
Amen.
Everybody here, the only thing you can do is sit here and line your life up and make sure you start obeying. If you ain't been doing it, start doing it. You got in the mind your soul. All you got to do you care about your soul? Who want to burn in hell? Let me ask this first. Who in here want to burn in hell? Well, this ain't hard then. What we got to do to avoid going to hell? We got to obey. We're going to have to obey and we're going to have to suffer. Just when you get it and you start obeying, you get it going, there's going to be some more things God's going to show you. Because he see you being pretty, if I see you pretty, do pretty good with that Sabbath, Leon, you be here every Sabbath. Try to start making them feast days. Start keeping them feast days, keep going. Then God going to give him some more thing going to reveal to him. But you got to work to obtain this stuff. For everybody looking for everything to fall on your plate at one time? A lot of stuff will overwhelm you. Just like when he brought the children of Israel, our forefather, out of Egypt. What did he do, brethren? He took them a long way. Why? He said, he could have brought them right out of Egypt, right into Jerusalem. But he said they would have seen war, you would have fainted. So God know you got to mature. The book says, as newborn babe, what you got to desire? That you might do what? Like, you can't start no baby out with no meat. You got to learn how to take milk to start, but then you got to grow. A lot of y'all sitting around, you're getting older, but you're still on the tent. He asked you in the 28th chapter of the book of Isaiah, what did he ask him? Whom shall he teach knowledge? And whom he going to make to understand? Him, them that are what? That drawn from the breast. I get you off the tent. You got to be weaned from the milk. How's she going to get understand? Some of the stuff y'all do, the same stupid, childish, dumb, retarded stuff you've been doing ever since you've been here. At what point do you change? At what point do you mature? Strong meat belong to them that are what? By reason of use and exercise, doing what? Huh? Baby, discern between good and evil. Got to discern decision making. Discern what's the consequence of when I make decision. What's the outcome if this should go bad or if it should go right? You got to consider all that. That comes with time maturing. And a lot of times, y'all got to sit here and y'all get past. Y'all friendship to each other sometimes, I tell y'all, be null and void ain't no good because you sit around and you ain't really real friend with each other, tell each other when you're wrong. I tell people they don't want to hear you wrong. I don't agree with you. Y'all hear me? That being friend, y'all, well, I don't want to offend them. I don't want to get upset with me. So you ready to go to hell with these people. Folks, the way we come along, the way we work, we tell folks some stuff, it's going to hurt your feelings. At the end of the day, your soul got to be saved. That's the only thing. Your soul, I want somebody to tell me the truth. Don't need mine to go to, you know what happened? A lot of y'all need my ex-pastor. He the best pastor for a lot of y'all. He the kind of dirty nigga you need. He'll talk behind your back, but he ain't going to tell you your face. That benefit a lot of people. He'll watch you go the wrong. He'll watch you get the wrong person. He'll watch you go the wrong way. He'll talk about it, laugh about it. And he'll leave you out there too. And he'll know it. You'll go ask him for some advice. I told him, he asked that fella about this boy, Cain and John, and asked him about a sister he was going to marry. And we sat there, we looked, and we laughed, because I just knew he shot him down. I was like, he asked about her. He was like, yeah. I said, what you telling? He said, I ain't telling him nothing. He said, he'll find out for himself. She the girl, I told y'all, she, listen, this girl blow up crackhead like balloons. She made crackhead start smoking dope. This girl right here, her name should have been Rehab. She getting out blowjobs, ain't talking about no checks either. Listen, you know how good you got to be make a crackhead start smoking dope. Here that boy Walden came here and asked his pastor about this sister. Was she a good sister? He was looking to ask her to marry and take her to meet his mama. He said, yeah, yeah. Sat that man right up to go out here and get that woman. I watched him then. I said, wow, that's pretty dirty. I couldn't believe it. Your pastor will set you up and send you out down a wild goose chase like that. He wouldn't tell you, he had to tell her business. He could tell, no. Why? What did I tell you? But you just gonna set that man, I hear that man uncane you for advice. That man look at you, you his shepherd, and you finna send that man out here on a wild goose chase. That girl ain't never been faithful to nothing. But that's what they do. A lot of y'all need him. He'll tell you what you want to hear. I'll tell you what you need to know. I'll tell you what you need to hear. Now, how you take when you get through with it, you don't have to eat that, and I ain't going to apologize either. Because you know, at the end of the day, your soul got to be saved. I got to give account for the advice I give. I give you some bad advice, and you out here and screw up. One, I'm going to have to pay for it. Two, I don't need my reputation messed up. I did enough of that when I was in the street. If I tell you something, that's what it is. Y'all hear me? You counting on me, right? I'm counting on God. I've been made a fool out of by preachers. I laugh down, look, I don't look at, well, somebody got me, I got to get somebody else. That's called retarded. That's called retarded. I go down the street and run over a bunch of nails, bust my tie. Now, ain't no use of me being the only one on the side of the road. Let somebody else come down and bust their tie. No, my end here, get in the street and try to stop them. Now, if you keep going, I told you, hey, slow down, go around. I tried to warn you. Versus sit here, a lot of y'all got that bad spirit. You think it's the right spirit, the wrong spirit. Y'all gotta get over the end and stop watching other people because other people mess up, other people wind up losing. You feel better about yourself. That's bad. Yep. I don't feel good about myself called Eddie Long failed. He should have failed. He was a false prophet. I don't feel good about myself called T.D. Jakes. I feel good about myself because I'm walking in God's word. I got a mind and an ear to hear God's word. I got a mind and ear to take God's correction. That's why I feel good about myself. You hear me? Because I can see the plan being revealed to us according to his writ. That's why I feel good about myself. Not because no false prophet. Y'all all right? Amen. Come on, son. Where did I get y'all? Come on, Luke 18 and 1. Come on.
And he spake a parable unto them to this end.
What did he say, son?
That men ought always to pray.
And not to what?
Faint.
Y'all hear what he said men ought to do? So, if I ought to always pray and not to, what is it?
Faint.
Faint is what you do when you get weak. That's what you do. So you got an option. I got weak. I get weak. I feel like quitting. What you need to do? He spoke a parable saying that. I don't feel like I can make it. I don't feel like I'm strong enough. What I need to do? That's what he told me to do. And not.
Faint.
He didn't give me an option to quit. So when who gave you your options? Was it either or? Faint or pray? Pray or not faint? He said, you ought to always pray and not to faint. I don't even gonna tell you that because I'm looking for something. I'm looking for a reason not to keep going. I'm looking for a reason to stop. I'm looking for a reason to give in. So he said, well, I'm gonna tell you something you ought to do. What is, you need to just keep praying and don't faint. Because the book taught in the book of Proverbs by the 24th chapter, if thou faint in the day of adversity, nobody told you to pray. Praying is of no avail to us if we don't have a mind to obey. When we pray, this is sincere talk to God. The eyes of the Lord are over. His ears are open unto. So he spake a parable to his enemy, men ought to always pray and not to faint. Was he talking to somebody living a contrary life? You see, when you start to set back to consider things, this is your option to keep from getting a contrary life. Before you go contrary, pray. Don't faint. Because once you faint, you put yourself in a situation where I can't help you. Because my eyes are over the righteous, my ears are open unto. But the face of the Lord is against them that do what? I just lost communication. How I'm going to get back to God? How I'm going to reconcile with God if I don't have no communication with God? So what God said and set up for us here, don't even put yourself in a situation where there's no communication. Instead of your fainting and giving in, won't you pray? In order to pray, you need to be obedient because you ain't going to get no results. Okay. Don't say you ain't been told. Come on, son.
Saying there was in a city a judge which feared not God.
And what else did he not do?
Neither regarded man.
What happened, son?
And there was a widow in that city.
Yeah.
And she came unto him, saying, avenge me of mine adversary.
Come on, son.
And he would not for a while.
Come
but
on.
But afterward, he said within himself.
What did he say?
Though I fear not God.
You hear what that man said? I don't fear God.
Nor regard man.
Neither do I regard man.
Yet because this widow troubleth me.
What happened, son?
I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me.
She'll weary me if I don't. What happened, son?
And the Lord said, hear what the unjust judge said.
He said, hear what the unjust judge said.
And shall not God avenge his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear long with them?
What do you think God's going to do if I keep praying? Day and night I keep praying. I stay consistent on the path of what I'm trying to do. What do you think God's going to do? He told y'all about a man in a city. He ain't regard nobody. Didn't respect God, nor did he have any regard for man. Yet this woman kept at him, continually staying at him. He said he had to avenge her, lest she was going to weary him. What you think God's going to do if I keep praying, keep asking? I'm going to pray one time, and nothing don't happen. That means God ain't going to save me. I'm going to pray two times, and nothing don't happen. That means God ain't going to save me. No, I'm going to pray without ceasing.
Amen.
No, I'm going to stay continuing. I'm going to keep calling on God because my soul got to be saved. Amen. I'm looking for God to give me the strength to be an overcomer. The only way they're going to happen, listen, everybody calling on God.
That's right.
What's different about them and you? Because you wrap your head? Because you don't wear no short pants? Because you don't smoke? There's a lot of people don't drink and don't smoke. There's a lot of people don't wear short pants because they got ugly legs. There's a lot of people don't wear a short sleeve because they got a lot of tattoos or somewhere got profanity on and they don't want to be seen. So what you're doing, a lot of people doing it for different reasons. So there's got to be something else that's going to single you out from other people to where God going to hear you. It's got to be your consistency. Y'all hear me?
Amen.
Got to be your consistency. There's a lot of people started. I remember one time, New Moon, everybody was coming. Mm-hmm. Folks started coming, folks started dying off, tweeting off, maybe not this week. How you beat people out? You stay consistent. Right. You learn to stay consistent. Sometimes people say, well, I ain't going to make this one. I ain't going to make that one. I don't know when. Once you set your mind to do something, this is what y'all all got to test and look at. Whether local or out of town, your object of being here is to secure your soul salvation. Y'all got me? That's the only reason. Y'all all remember why you're here. You're only here for one thing. This is to secure your soul salvation. In securing your soul salvation, you will find some things written that are required in order for these actions to happen. You have to set in your mind to look and make sure you meet all of the criteria, else your soul ain't gonna be saved. If it's actually 613 laws, all you need to do is obey 610, and you will have disobeyed all 613. If you do 612, you just sat here and you broke 613. The mindset is to make sure you're following. When you set yourself to do something, he already knows stuff going to come up. Unless Satan hindered me, if I'm sick, it's beyond my control. If Paul desired to be someone, he said, but Satan hindered him. You set your mind for the sake of, in order to get what you're trying to get with God, you got to be able to do something that only a few men and women will do. Let's see something. I'm going to try to let y'all go. Hebrews 11 chapter. Give me verse 18. We'll just read down. I really need y'all to lay the heart. What y'all need to do is save your soul. I really do. Some of y'all will sit down and talk about their husband and wife. Ain't nothing wrong with that. At the end of the day, though, look at people and know what you got to do for yourself. You got to look at what you got to do for yourself. Let me tell you something. If you got a mind to go file an application, get a job, you got a mind to go online and do school work and enroll in school and get in subjects and go to college, you got enough sitting here with that book say.
Amen.
You ain't doing crazy. Like I said, ain't falling down. Don't put that falling down the steps on me, nigga. The rent due. You can go do all this other stuff out here y'all want to do. You got enough sin to obey God's word. It's a matter of what you want to do. And when God get back in, you'll wish you had. Come on, listen.
Of whom it was said that in Isaac shall thy seed be called.
Come on, son.
Accounting that God was able to raise him up even from the dead, from whence also he received him in a figure.
Come on.
By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning things to come.
Come on.
By faith, Jacob, when he was a dying, blessed both the sons of Joseph and worshiped, leaning upon the top of his staff. By faith, Joseph, when he died, made mention of the departing of the children of Israel and gave command.
What are they going to do with that? Man sick, he on top of a staff, still worshiping. Man, oh, y'all know what y'all do. Y'all are sick here. Y'all succumb to sickness. Y'all succumb to any foolish to come along. You don't realize, y'all ain't doing nothing different. That's your problem. You ain't doing nothing different. Why Isaac didn't sit around? Why Jacob didn't just sit around looking at, well, I'm old now, I'm sick. Ain't nothing I can do for the Lord. The book said he would lean on his staff, still worshiping. What y'all going to do? Y'all don't, let me tell you something. Y'all come over this stuff. Let me tell you something. There's not one member in here from Sister Nikki to any one of y'all, Sister Keita, me and nobody here, and nobody in this camera got no excuse for not doing what God tell them to do. Not one of us. You ain't done that nobody before, you ain't done. Sometimes we'll say, well, my sit, I got a day in my head hurt, I just can't get the bed going. But you know what, at the end of the day, they ain't got nothing to do with what I got to do for God. Because if that's all I'm going to do, if I'm only going to be good to God when it allows me, he really can't use me. Because when sitting and come, who I'm going to obey? When trouble come, or kids come, who you going to obey? I got folks, some having their child, they gone. They got to go get them. They got to go do whatever. You think God can use you? He realized it's too easy for you to fall. All the devil got to do is let something happen to your child. Where you at? It's I can't use you. A lot of us, you know the truth be told, a lot of us are here. God can't even use you. Got too much stuff going on. He done invited y'all to come to a wedding supper, but you just cannot come. It's just some place you just cannot go. Y'all got to get your mindset, folks. It don't matter what you got. Listen, who y'all think put us all in these situations? Who? How did I get my blood pressure? White man? Government? God had to give it to me. And God gave it to me and let me know, guess what? Not one tally of brick supposed to be altered. God got a prayer to be built. And that blood pressure ain't got nothing to do with it. God know what he gave me when it come down to it. What you supposed to do? A man like Moses. Moshe, he go here and the Most High God speed him, tell him, go down and I want you to talk to my people and tell Pharaoh to let my people go. I ain't gonna be able to go. Well, my tongue. Who made man mouth? He said, who made the halt, the dumb, or the lame? He said, don't let the Lord do all these things. So if I told you to do something, don't you think I already knew what your situation was? What you doing trying to tell me about it? God got angry with it. Because if I told you to do something, I don't care about your sickness now. I know what I told you to do. Which means for every one of us in here, you got to push past whatever your obstacles are. I have other obligations. I can have some stuff I'm supposed to do. I just can't do it sometimes. They come out doing their job. I had to look and consider. Now, if you can't do it, I don't want you to stress yourself. Because I got somebody that can do it. And for whatever reason it is, I can get the strength to get up and do it. Because I know once he got somebody to go ahead and do it, you just take your rest. I don't want nothing to happen to you. You take care of that blood pressure. And like the way you go, it's going to be real high. So you try to rest up now. Everybody here got to consider that. None of these things change any requirements. There's not, let me just see a book for a minute. I don't know. I'm getting old. Give me a second. I know it's in him. No, I can't. I was trying to find out about the requirement if you got blood pressure, about what you had to do to be saved. I couldn't find it. I was trying to find out where it said if you're in a wheelchair, if you had, what's the name of the illness you got, Sister Keena? Vertigo. I was trying to find an entity. Maybe you got any illness? None of them in there. For none of us. You got diabetes on it. I ain't see it in there for you either. Mother, you got high blood pressure on it. It wasn't in there for you either. What about you, what you got? High blood pressure and diabetes. It wasn't in no combo in there. What you got? Your Achilles be hurt. It wasn't in there either. Who else got something? Anybody else got anything? What you got, Brother Lincoln? He said, I know it. Yes, it was something about an ass and a hell about Balaam smoked that ass. I saw that in that. Well, I mean, I can't lie. It's in there, ain't it? Now, go ahead. His knee. Ain't nothing in there about the knee. Anybody got anything else? Insomnia. Wasn't nothing in there. What you got? High blood. I ain't seen that for you either. Anybody else? What you got? His eyes? Nothing. Diabetes? Nothing. Your hip? Nothing. I say that for everybody here, which means when God made every one of us and formed us from the womb before we got here, this was already written. You know what he knew when he wrote this? He knew it would be people like us that were going to have high blood pressure, they would have diabetes, vertigo, hip problems, whatever it might be, whatever the illness any of us got, eyes, whatever it might be, that's going to use it versus what did I tell you? He knew there would be people that were going to use that, and he knew there were going to be some people that were going to look at, ain't nothing to him about this. When we talked about the 30th chapter of the book of Exodus, everybody had to, from 20 years old and up, what you had to give? Somebody said sexual what? I ain't hear sexual, Dylan. Oh, it sounded like this, like sexual healing. Stop it, Marvin Gaye. So he knew that there were going to be some people that were going to look at their illness, and their illness wasn't going to be hindering them from doing what he said do, which means that put the mark real high. See, had there never been anybody with an illness that had ever served him before, had never completed and did what he said, every one of us would be good. Because when he come back here, I tell him straight to his face. Who had high blood pressure here was able to do it? He said, well, you got me on that one. Nobody never did it. You can tell him about diabetes. If nobody had never done it. What I'm saying, diabetes, if it hadn't been anybody that had had any affliction that had never completed what he told him to do, everybody here would be free. Y'all got me? But because there were people that continue and believe and kept the obligation despite of, that made everybody here accountable. Y'all got me? That made everybody here accountable. Let's look at something real quick. Fifth chapter, book of St. John. St. John 5:1. Y'all give me a minute. All I want to end the day, everyone is to be saved. Young people, I talk to y'all all the time, tell y'all, just get saved. That's all. Everybody here, just get saved. It's hard. Get saved. Man, y'all purchase that in your heart to be saved. It's going to pay off. Ain't nothing going to pay more dividend than being saved. Man, I'm living better than I ever lived in my life. Do I have a problem? Yes. Do things not come in? Yes. At the end of the day, going to hell ain't my biggest fight. Get past that lot of that stuff. It's a fight. It's a struggle, but you can do it. If everybody did what a lot of y'all do, give in and succumb to it, you're done. If everybody, listen, had it not been for all these folk that came before me and paid the way, I wouldn't be here tonight. I woke up, I told my wife, my head was ringing. I took a blood pressure, and it got worse. I just laid out and be like, my head is killing me. Then I turned my bed on and let it vibrate. I said, maybe it just vibrate. It made my head wave. It was like, why did I turn that bed on? It just made it hurt worse. At the end of the day, that part I got to suffer with. I'll tell you what I didn't think about doing. Questioning God, cussing God, stop going and serving God. None of those came up. You know what came up? I just had to talk to him. Head hurting everything. I just got to keep talking to him. I got to keep going. I'm here now. I'm here now. I could have did everything other folk do. Why, oh Lord, why had thou forsaken me? What I require you to do, son? What I require you to do, everybody got to do it. And then the sad part, you know what he tell me? It's my reasonable service. I'm doing my reasonable service. Come on, look at it. Fifth chapter of the book of St. John. Listen.
After this, there was a feast of the Yehudians, and Yeshua went up to Jerusalem.
Come on, son.
Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having five porches.
Listen.
In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water.
What were they? Who were there now?
Blind.
Blind.
Halt.
Halt.
Withered.
Withered.
Waiting for the moving of the water.
Halt, can't walk. Blind. Folk withered, hand decrepit. And these folk waiting here by the pool, what are they waiting on, son?
Waiting for the moving of the water.
Man, that's why I'm here, man. I'm waiting. I'm waiting on the, God gonna move the water. They have something, God gonna trouble the water. That's why I'm here. I'm here, I ain't going nowhere. I'm gonna keep coming. That's why y'all give up, I gotta keep coming. I'm waiting on God to move the water. It gonna tide, gonna turn. They did it before. When we came out of Egypt, we had nowhere to go. If you wait, I'm gonna move the water. Come on, son.
For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water.
Lord have mercy. Come on, son.
Whosoever then first after the troubling
what
of the water.
What you gonna do with that? Let's just pay simple attention. At that season. It's only one time this happened. Season. Ain't but two seasons we got. That was a time period when an angel would come down, stir up the water, and whosoever, what was the word?
Then first.
That's right there. Stop everything. Now, how in the world, every one of us in here going to be first? How that going to happen? It's going to be impossible. It's not, even we said on the count of three, that somebody going to be a fraction of hair. It's got to be. You going to miss it. Ain't but one going to get it. But look here. Halt, blind, lame, all these folks, and wither, all these folks laying him. What happened, son?
For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had.
You know somebody jumped in there while it was still trouble. A nigga trying to be smart. Think it's like it from the start. It's just like you to play, you go around that chair. You ain't start yet, you start dragging. You don't want me, you hate to get on that backside. That when you move fast. You on that front side, you be trying to sit down and the music ain't even stop. So you know a nigga gonna jump in there early. But it gotta be after the trouble. So you know what we look at and we learn from this? You wanna know when your healing gonna come? Wait till trouble get gone. It makes sense. Wait till your trouble get gone. After the trouble, God gonna heal us. He said, whosoever first step in, who's still standing? Why the water be in trouble? Who gonna stand? Right now, I look at things in my life going, right now I got trouble. But wait after this stop. I'm looking to step in. Everybody, you gotta set your mind for something. Then only way you look to get to your healing, trouble gotta happen. That water gotta come in, it gotta get desperate. That water gotta get stirred up. That water gotta get tossed and moving. And as soon as this stop, that's when your healing coming. So why ain't healed right now? Water still trouble. Water still trouble. But after a while, when that water stop, I'm looking to step in. I'm looking to be made whole. Come on, son.
And a certain man was there which had an infirmity.
What was that man's name? Cause they ain't got nothing to do with God healing you. That's what nigga worry about. Let me see, bro. It's all false. Because don't even tell me what the man's name is. They ain't got nothing to do with you being healed. If he told you, it wouldn't change the validity of the story. There was a certain man. Tell him about the man, son.
Which had an infirmity 38 years.
What happened?
When Yeshua saw him lie and knew that he had been now a long time in that case.
Lord have mercy. How long you been dealing with vertigo? Your mommy asked this way. 6 years? Nicky, how long Nicky been in that condition, Chris? 2 years. Mother, how long you been dealing with blood pressure? I've been dealing with it about 8 years. Man, how about you, mother, diabetes and blood pressure? Since she was in her 20, about 40 years probably. How long you been dealing with it? Huh? 3 years. Every one of these conditions we got, you think he don't know that? When he come out, you think he don't know how long we've been dealing with this stuff? Man, you think he don't know how long we've been dealing with it? That's why he came by to sin. You've been there with a long time. You've been there with a long time. But here we got a man sitting here. Listen to the story.
He saith unto him, wilt thou be made whole?
What happened, son?
The impotent man answered him, sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but while I am coming, another steppeth down before me.
What happened, son?
Yeshua saith unto him, rise, take up thy bed and walk.
What we find here, a lot of time, we wind up letting other people get in the way of our deliverance. I'm not talking about natural, but spiritually. A lot of time we account that we need somebody in order to get what we need from the Most High God. He looked at, I'm this close, but I don't have nobody to help me. If you consistent in what you're doing, he provide the help.
Amen.
That's why he said, the day of salvation, I know I help you. Why people quit and tell me what they've been doing? They ain't suffering nothing. In due time, don't you know, if I stay consistent, don't y'all know God gonna heal me? I ain't even talking about the blood pressure. That's not even something I'm looking for. I don't pray to God about. If you move, I don't have them prayer. I don't never ask. If you did something with their blood pressure, I don't have that prayer. Blood pressure, this blood pressure right here is a Kodesh blood pressure. It go to service on Sabbath day, Wednesday, it keep feast days. This one right here is unlike any other blood pressure. It don't drink and fornicate, it don't commit. This blood pressure, this is a clean blood pressure. It might get high. It's high because it's clean. I keep it clean. Y'all hear me? I keep it separated. Isn't that right? I make it religious. So whatever it's going to do, it got to do it while it's going to do it. I'm finna cut the food. Well, you going to cut the food at service. Ain't that right? I'm going to get you saved. That blood pressure will go, hallelujah! Make that thing loose. It's going to be right. Take it on to the kingdom. Now, I say that to say that if your mind is set to really be saved, your condition don't stop that. A lot of times we forget about these things that's written. Whatsoever written aforetime, written for our what? That we through patience and comfort of the scripture. Now, if he can do that for Moses, he can prepare speech for Moses and fix Moses' mouth. What you think God will do for me if I stay consistent? If my mind is set to do what God told without question, without reservation, don't you know God gonna make preparation for me? All that man had to do was stop year two, year seven, year 25, year 28, year 30, year 33, year 34, year 37. That could have been it, 37. That's done, I ain't going this year. How am I going this year? No, Leon, I ain't gonna be able to make it, bro. Pray for me, though. That could be the time when your deliverance finna come. That's the time when he looked here, when he explained why he was laying there, he said, take up your bed and walk. Only reason he could do that, you believe me enough to be him when I told you. He ain't looking and saying, well, you know, that's for people well to go. That didn't make sense, because the pool was for whoever stepped in after troubling the water, man. Everybody that was here didn't have no reason to get in the pool. And for people that sick, he told you, who need a physician? Not them that may hold. That's why we here. You need one naturally in spirit. That sometimes when these afflictions come, it's to set here to show you, you got to suffer the inner end. You got to overcome the inner end. The people we followed, that's what they did. Man, you're 100 years old, you got to go make a baby. That's suffering. Hey, Malcolm. When you was 100, Malcolm, first, you weren't thinking about no kids, was you? He was telling Cain, Abraham, y'all boys going out there playing. When you get 100, you're going to see things going to change. Isn't that right? I'm saying there are a lot of people that suffer and overcome. You're going to have some battles in your life. Abraham had to go out to fight to bring back what was taken. And that's the same man you got to have. We're trying to restore something with God. Which means you got to set yourself, stop finding reasons to quit. Quit believing in your situation and believe in God. I watch some of y'all succumb to stuff. Y'all face showing. Y'all just look burnt to it. You look like you just defeated to it. And where you think your deliverance is going to come from? Once you succumb to it, it's going to take you. The book said, by whom a man is overcome, the same as he what? He'll be brought into bondage. How the world I'm going to get you pink? Let me stop for him, just you. I'm saying, man, I got you like this. He talking about, you ain't got me. You ain't got me. This retarded. If I've overcome, if then you in bondage to me. I'm saying that that's the same mind. Once you give in this stuff, it's going to bring you into bondage. It's going to make you a slave on the other end. It's going to pull you away from your mind. Still got to be to still serve God. When Paul looked at, when he was saying here, when he was stuck with an affliction, he realized that when he sought the Most High God, he said, my grace is sufficient. My strength is made perfect when. That's how I keep going. God be my strength. I used to wonder how that worked. We don't feel like going, folks say you still. I used to sit and listen to people talk. I say, that was wrapped up in a enigma. I didn't understand what that meant. When you don't feel like going and you get to God, I say, if I don't feel like going, why would I go? How many of y'all remember folks say stuff? You be like, I don't know, but you just said like you understand it. You be like, I thank the Lord for my good days and my bad days. I thank the Lord for my aches and pains. I just said I'm looking for, I be saying to myself, these people are freaky. How you just thank God for some aches and some pains? For some good, I wouldn't know I had good days and one for my bad days. It because of the thing that God allowed me to suffer that I come to appreciate things and realize I took a lot of stuff for granted. I'm telling you, in life, you can take a lot of stuff for granted. God changed things. God can change your situation. People don't realize little simple stuff like blood pressure. Man, that stuff can shoot so high, you can be taking your pill, doing what you're supposed to do. That stuff will still just shoot all out the way. And that thing of you laying up in the hospital, folks sitting there with tubes, and you saying, how did I get him? God said, God suffered. He just started letting you just know how frail your life is. Diabetes. You could be taking your stuff, eat something wrong. That thing, you know, you're having a diabetes, having a diabetic coma, come on, almost stroke or something. And you feel like, how did I get here? God letting you know, that's just how temporal your life is. It's in my hand. Medication or no medication, I got control over you. It takes sometimes these sickness ailments to make us consider. Look at Sister Nikki. We remember she was a prominent member. Up and going and singing. Up and laughing and talking. God in control of everybody's situation in him. Right. I'm laying it flat to every one of y'all. Yo, you ain't in control of nothing. Not one of y'all overcame nothing. You got what God gave you. Your health is good because God gave it. Your health is bad because God gave it to you. And when God get ready, God will change it. Hell, he lived it for 38 long years, that man suffered. All you got to do is wait on Yeshua to come by. That's all you got to wait on. But you got to be consistent. I get y'all. Y'all will kill me. Y'all have to. When I'm going to get saved. How long you been obeying? It's been 20 minutes. Put gear 20 more. What's going to happen? You're going to have 40 minutes. And you put 15 more, and you put 20 more, you're going to have an hour. And you can get you about 12 of them things, you're going to have half a day. And you put you about 12 more, you're going to have a whole day, you're going to be able to live right. Then what I'm going to do, try to see if you can make a nerd. Make a nerd. Then you're going to have 2 days. Isn't that right? And the third day, what's going to happen? You're going to need the fourth day. Keep pushing, you get a week. What'll happen there? You keep pushing a week, you're going to hit a month. Then what's going to happen? Keep hitting the month. You don't hit a year. Yep. Ain't that right? You what I'm doing here, if you keep working like you did the first time, you should get another year in. Right. That's what do? You keep living right till the man change your life. Right. You keep living right till the man see you with the Ruach HaKodesh. Right. Folks keep looking for a time stamp. He knows as soon as you get one, you'll work, then you'll stop. Right. He will work unto death. He told you to be faithful unto death. I'll give you a crown of life. That's why the man kept coming. If you really don't like your situation, do something to change it. But you set back, you mill it back, you give in, you quit, you stop, you look half dead to it, then what you think gonna happen? They gonna pull me away from what I'm doing. I get my mindset on serving God. I had to put that blood pressure stuff behind me. They gotta do what they gotta do. Sometimes I had to pray and say, listen, if you just let me get through what I need to do for you. I said, whatever happened after that, then I had to deal with it. He had to look at a man that'll say that. Look at verses saying, if you can just do like you did for Joshua, make the sun stand still for the space of a whole day. If you can do like Hezekiah and make the sundial go back. Huh? If you can do like you did for Moses, if you just raise up my arm and just hold me just a little while off of what, so I can go by the hospital and I can still make the service, I don't be late. He's a nigga, please. I thought you were talking about something. Isn't that right? Oh, you had me do it for you. God looking for somebody. Can he want to get the glory out of it? You will still go with what you're dealing with? You will still believe in spite of how your life is gone? That's what God looking at. That's what God looking at. Who doing something? Why you think he picked that man? Because they've been folk. They did a couple years. They stopped. You've been here 38 long years. 38 long years. You still came. And what were the probability you were going to get? He said, I ain't had nobody put me in. You know what? There's no way I'm going to keep coming. I'm just believing God by somebody, somehow, some way going to help me get in that water. How many of y'all can be consistent for 38 years? Some of y'all ain't been consistent the time you've been here. Some of y'all ain't been here 10, 11, and you said, how long, in the 10, 11 years, how long you been consistent? Why would you go looking to be like this man? That's why these stories seem so far-fetched. Because here you see a man with consistency for 38 long years. 38 long years. You think as far as he go was just to the pool? He had to have a mind to hear God's word. You got to have a mind to be on the Sabbath feast. Why would God come to live with him? You hadn't been doing nothing. He said, I got to work the work of him while it's called what? Because when the night comes, no man can work well. So if all you got is just enough to get here, you can't get the service, you can't make no feast there, you can't obey, it don't make sense to heal you. I bet that'd be pretty aggravating. 38 years, this nigga called me, talking about pick him up and drop my name. That got to be pretty aggravating. But the man's on a mission. I got to get there. That's the mindset we got to get. At some point, do something different. At some point, get a mind to get consistent. Stop thinking week and months and days, folks. You got to think about, I got to do this till I die. That's where y'all mess up at. The course I'm on ain't for a week or month. I'm doing this till I die. When I learn better, then I'm going to do something else even better than what I'm doing. You got to stay consistent. Stay past it. Once you get saved, then see, then all things, if you taste and fall away, then what happened? It's impossible to know you again and repent. So you still got work when you get it. What you think the devil going to work hard at? Somebody trying to be saved or somebody saved? Saved. Say, I got to get you to unseal this. Somebody trying to be saved ain't sealed the deal. Somebody say, seal the deal. If I get him to fall away, it's impossible to know you again unrepentant. Who you think I'm going to work hard at? Because once I get you off, somebody trying to be saved, you mess up, you still got a chance. He ain't taking him fall away. If he give God, give him the mind, you still got a chance. But he messed around, I'm taking him fell away there. The impossible knew me again unrepentant. Saying, I done crucified the Lord of prayer, brought him to open shame. Huh? He going to get somebody that after coming to the knowledge of the truth, it don't make no sacrifice for sin. Them the people he going to want to stop. So your fight don't change, folks. It only intensifies. Some folks, once I get saved, once you get saved, you got to be saved until you come back here. Right. So nobody got it easy. Quit getting in your mind this easy way. If it were easy, everybody be doing it. Y'all think people just walking off from family and job, careers, moving from homes and losing cars because it's easy? Because if you're going to be saved, you're going to have to sacrifice. Everybody got to do it. You're going to have to sacrifice how you feel and how you think if you're going to be saved. It's a sacrifice. Finish that 11th chapter for me. Hebrews. Jump on down to 28 so I can let them go. I appreciate y'all. Hopefully it helps somebody tonight. Like I said, I can't help everybody, but hopefully somebody helped tonight. Listen to the book.
Through faith, he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood, lest he that destroyed the firstborn should touch them. By faith, they passed through the Red Sea as by dry land.
You hear that? That was by faith. Had never happened before. Well, I don't believe it's going to happen now. I just believe God's word. See, a lot of folks come in here and they keep the Passover. It ain't by faith. We keep the Lord. So we ought to drink out one cup. You don't know what nobody can have. By faith. Who always take it last? Whatsoever not of faith? Sin. Got to be that way. I can't ask y'all to do nothing I wouldn't do. So I said, what I do, I take it last. They had to look and say, well, if he's taking it last, it must not be bad. I'd have drank behind all y'all. Some of y'all breath so rotten, nothing but Duke-a-later. But you know what I look at? I'd have do what God told me by faith. They had no Colgate, no Dentine back then. I believe God's word. You think I'd be the last one to take because I believe God's word. Why am I ask y'all to do something I wouldn't do? Amen. I believe God's word. Y'all hear me? Amen. Listen.
Which the Egyptians, essaying to do, were drowned.
Come on.
By faith, the walls of Jericho fell down after they were compassed about 7 days.
Thank the Lord, he saved my breath, too. Do my breath be smell like doo-doo? Thank the Lord. Said by faith. I can be around, man, have a done turtle laid in my mouth, messed up. God faithful. It's funny to God, because some of y'all breath got the marty. You can switch lips with your anal. Both of them smell are doing the same. I believe God's word. I do. I believe. I don't even think of them. You know what I do? I just believe God's word. Some of y'all talking numbers, straight mess. You know what? I'm serious. I just believe God. I do. I believe. I don't be saying, don't. I only ask to keep that breath out of my mouth. I only ask. I take it. I do. Well, I say, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, I take it by faith. You know, a lot of folks ain't going to do that. Man, y'all look at. Man, after about 1 or 2, you just get that cup. Man, even take that cup, man. But you believe God's word, what you going to do? They kept it by faith. Listen.
By faith, the harlot Rahab perished not with them that believe not.
Come on, son.
When she had received the spies with peace. And what shall I more say? For the time would fail me to tell of Gideon, and of Barak, and of Samson, and of Jephthah, of David also, and Samuel, and of the prophets.
Come on.
Who through faith subdued kingdoms.
Y'all see they did through faith. What else, son?
Wrought righteousness.
Come on.
Obtained promises.
Mm-hmm.
Stopped the mouths of lions.
Come on.
Quenched the violence of fire.
Come on.
Escaped the edge of the sword.
Come on.
Out of weakness were made strong.
Mm-hmm.
Waxed valiant in fight. Turned to flight the armies of the aliens.
Mm-hmm.
Women received their dead raised to life again.
Mm-hmm.
And others were tortured.
Mm-hmm.
Not accepting deliverance. That they might obtain a better resurrection.
Come on, son.
And others had trial of cruel mocking and scourgings.
Come on.
Yea, moreover, of bonds and imprisonment.
Come on.
They were stoned, they were sawn asunder, were tempted, were slain with the sword.
Y'all hear that? What were they? Hold on, back me up. They were sawn asunder. What else they did?
They were stoned, they were sawn asunder.
What happened?
Were tempted.
Lord have mercy. With all this going on, they were tempted. Ain't nothing new. That's gonna happen. You think because all that was going on, they weren't tempted? Somebody finna throw you in a fiery furnace. Come on now, what's your first mind? Bow down or go in the fiery furnace. What's your first mind? God ain't made nobody stupid. You know what you can do? You can bow down and don't believe. When then what you can do when you escape it without going, then you can work for the greater good. God set up the well, it's gotta be that way. You either all the way with me or you not. And you know what? That's how it happened with us. We all got to be tested. A lot of times when tests come, it just shows you where your heart is. Sometimes we'll think we're perfect with God. Sometimes we'll feel like we're all right with God. But when these tests come up, it shows us, I ain't where I thought I was. So what I need to do? Quit, stop, run off, come up to tomorrow. When tests come, just like when they give you tests in school. Do they give you tests in school so you drop out the class? The tests are set to see where you're at. Then we know what areas you got in it. So I know when I pull your test and I see your reading score, it tells me I need to work with you more on reading. When I see your math score, I need to work with you more on math. I see your science score. That's why you have, so when God give you tests, it ain't so you quit. It's so we can see where your strong points are, where your weak points at. So we work on the weak points, so we make them, try to get them equivalent with the other strong points. This is the mindset y'all got to have you hearing God's word. You don't keep succumbing to the same stupid stuff. In order to get different test scores, we got to start working on them, trying to set the curriculum where it starts to favor you to where that area becomes a little better. Y'all got me? So when the word coming correction hits you, it's so we can get you to be better in that area. When the conviction comes, it's to pull you away from that area. Come on.
We're slain with the sword.
Come on.
They wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented, of whom the world was not worthy.
Come on.
They wandered in deserts and in mountains and in dens and caves of the earth.
Come on.
And these all having obtained a good report.
That's what I love, Leon. That's good. That's beautiful. Give him a hand clap, y'all. And I say that in no way being funny, because Tony Smith ain't been in no lying den. Tony Smith ain't been no fire, ain't been slain, ain't been stoned, ain't none of this stuff done happened. Y'all ain't want to buy no sheepskin, ain't went about with doubt and destitute or none of this stuff. But with all that happening, these having did what, Brandon?
And these all having obtained a good report.
That's pretty good report now. I heard about your report. Old folk call it a report. Con, where your report card at? That's a pretty good report. Through faith. What they do now? What you say they got?
Receive not the promise.
Couldn't get no A for that, though. What happened, son?
God, having provided some better thing for us.
That's what I love about it, folks. We just take that thing and believe it and do it. God provided some better things for us. That they without who?
Without us.
Could not do what?
Should not be made perfect.
I don't know how. We had to come. What they did and set to pave way for us to come, pave way for us to come. Man, that was beautiful. That was a good report, huh? Didn't get no promise, though. God provided some better things for us. They without us, they couldn't be made perfect. Now we come along because somebody got to believe what they did. I'm standing up. They say, you stupid. You ain't been in a fire furnace. Not at all. You been in the lion den. Do you know what lions do to a human? You ever went to the zoo and seen them zookeeper going out with a lion? Do you not know what a lion will do to you? Yeah, I know what they'll do. And you believe that? I got to believe it. God provided some better thing for us. Hmm? Man, it's harder than believe than to stand in there and do it. Because what common sense you put a human being out with a lion? You know, they show you every time, look around, you hear these white folk getting mauled. Don't be us. They showed a white boy on the news today, poor thing. He was in there telling about how he not finna let that shark bite stop him. He said, all of that shark came and bit me off up to him. He said, I'm gonna still keep going. He not gonna alter my life. I said, you dumb little white boy. I've been a holler that nigga. I've been hollering and pooping and messing. Where am I blanking on? Where am I on? I've been doing this. Man, please. This is the mindset. Folk won't suffer for God. He don't hold no ill feeling with the shark. Man, I been where that nigga at? I'm gonna put some hands on it. Ain't no way, people mind bad. He said that shark ain't finna alter his life. That nigga done nubbed him almost to the ear, and he's still good. Hey man, I'm just, people mind, I'm blown. But when it come down to believing what God ain't asked us to do, none of this crazy fool these people do. But yet we selling the stuff God asked us to do, we find it so hard for us to do. These sinners show us up. Stick, 16, you done lost your arm. You good, they ain't gonna alter your life. I'm 41, they gonna mess me up. Good, Leon, because I want to change your seat. I'm sorry, be 41. October. How many of y'all love the Lord? Say you don't love the Lord. Thank y'all for believing in me. So don't let nobody make no fool out of y'all. God done set something better for us. We ain't got to go do that. We ain't got to go get no line down. All I got to do is believe it. That's all we got to do is believe. Let me show y'all something. 20th chapter of the book of St. John. For whatever reason it is, the Lord got us going their way, you need to hear it. 20th chapter of the book of St. John. Give me about verse 25. Matter of fact, make it 2019 first. Come on.
Then the same day at evening, being the first day of the week.
What happened, son?
When the doors were shut, where the disciples were assembled.
Is that you breathing in that mic like that when you talking? Are you
fan blown.
Oh, the fan. Oh, sorry, man. Go ahead.
When the doors were shut, where the disciples were assembled for fear of the Yehudans, came Yeshua and stood in the midst.
Come on.
And said unto them, peace be unto you.
Come on.
And when he had said so, he showed unto them his hands and his side.
He showed them his hands and his side. What happened?
Then were the disciples glad.
Then were the disciples what?
Glad.
When were they glad?
When they saw the Lord.
Verse 25.
The other disciples therefore said unto him, we have seen the Lord.
The other disciples said unto Philip, Thomas, we have seen the Lord. What happened?
But he said unto them,
except what?
I shall see in his hands the print of the nails.
Except I shall see in his hand the print of the nail.
And put my finger into the print of the nail.
And I got to put my fingers into the print of the nail.
And thrust my hand into his side.
And I got to take my hand and put it in his side. What you going to do, Thomas?
I will not believe.
Wow. He could have just said, unless I see it. Unless I got some more witnesses. Or if y'all got a picture. Or if he left a note. Or did he leave y'all a word for me? Did the man of God leave a word for me? This man said, not only I got to see it, I'm going to have to put my hand in it. And I ain't just got to look at it. I'm going to have to put my hand in his side. I ain't going to believe it. Come on, son.
And after 8 days again,
what happened?
His disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Then came Yeshua, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst and said, peace be unto you.
Peace be unto you.
Then said he to Thomas,
do what?
Reach hither thy finger.
And what?
Behold my hand.
Come on.
And reach hither thy hand.
Uh-huh.
And thrust it into my side.
And what he want me to do?
And be not faithless.
Be not what?
Faithless.
But what?
Believing.
And what happened?
And Thomas answered and said unto him,
my who?
Lord.
And my who?
God.
Listen.
Yeshua said unto him,
what did he tell him?
Thomas, because thou hast seen me.
Because thou have what?
Seen me.
Tell him what happened, son.
Thou hast believed.
Tell me what else happened, son.
Blessed are they that have not seen
yet,
and yet have believed.
They can't be made perfect without us. Somebody got to believe. That's why I'm here. Somebody got to believe. That's my blessing. I ain't got to see no. God ain't helping me. I ain't never tell him, if you could just ease your hand right in front of my face, let me touch it real quick. Man said, if I'm blessed, if I don't see it, then believe. 1 Peter chapter 1 right quick. Wonderful Savior. Amen. 1 Peter 1 and 8. Listen.
Whom having not seen.
Uh-oh. Whom?
Having not seen.
What happened?
Ye love.
And what happened?
In whom, though now ye see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable
and
full of glory.
What happened?
Receiving the end of your faith.
Receiving the what?
End of your faith.
What I'm receiving?
The end of your faith.
Tell them what I'm going to get, son.
Even the salvation of your souls.
I ain't got to see everything God do for me to believe it. See, God got something. He done provided some better thing for us. A lot of them, it was a seal for them. Even with Jacob. Jacob said, if the Lord bring me back into the land of my father, if he give me food to eat and raiment to wear, so I come again into my father's house, then I'm going to give him a tenth of everything I got, and he going to be my God. I hadn't said that. He ain't got to take me back in Jerusalem for me to be my God. God hadn't provided some better thing for us. I can die and don't go. All I ask y'all to do is take my bones with you. I still believe. Y'all don't realize how blessed we are today. We'd be in a mess if all I had to make that lion den. Man, them lion breath be so stinker. You know how much y'all mess. Y'all, man, them lion breath be so, they be like, I don't even want none. You a mess so bad. The point becoming, a lot of times y'all don't look at, all we got to do is believe their testimony. God done set up, we ain't got to go here and be wandering in the wheel. You ain't got to be walking, getting beat and doing all these different things, folks trying to set themselves up to try to show they saved. Reenacting, putting themselves on the cross. The man done provided some better things for us. Right. Meaning when a situation come up, all I got to do is believe God to do it. That's all I got to do, believe in my heart. I got to believe God to do it. Y'all hear? And if he don't do it, it ain't because he ain't able. He done provided some better things for us. We are sitting here standing on the promises that these men sat here and these folks waxed through to try to get and then receive it. God provided where we can get it. You know what them folks would have did? They worked to get the Ruach HaKodesh. Couldn't even get it. God has provided some better things for us. Set us up, said, whom, Peter said, whom you haven't seen, and you still rejoicing, and with joy and speak with, and full of glory. Sometimes you get choked up, you can't tell it. It can't even speak it. Full of glory. You know it takes something to have a mind to do that? Y'all just don't realize how blessed we are tonight. Not just the night, just the mere fact God set this up. That all you got to do is believe it. I ain't talking about that fake nigga, but believe it to the saving of the soul. Peter said, that's what you believe for. You look and receive the end of your faith. These folks talking about they got salvation. Salvation is not to them, man. Come back here. You're on the premises of the promise of salvation. Because you can give up. You can stop and turn away. But you got to believe to the end. That's why Hebrew told we none of them that draw back under position. We them that believe. Only reason to draw back is to go ahead and fall away. When David had taken Uriah's wife, he sent a letter and sealed it and gave it to Uriah to give to the captain of the host. And the letter read that he had him going to take his part and told him that when the battle get hot, what did he tell him to do? Draw back. Draw back. Only when they drew back, what you think? Why were they told to draw back? Because I already knew what was going to happen. When we draw back, somebody's going to get killed. That's why Hebrew let you know. We're not of them that draw back under perdition. It was already set up to draw back for this man to be killed. That's not us. Why are we going to sit here and draw back? Our mind to keep going forward. Just like we got to the Red Sea. Go forward. You don't see it. You got to believe, don't you? Go forward. What else you going to do? I can't stop. What am I going to do, turn around? This is your mission. Every one of y'all here, this is your mission. Go forward. Sick, well, high blood pressure, trouble, finance, husband, wife, go forward. That's how we're going to make it in. That's good, brother.